We now have the tools to encrypt data asymmetrically and to sign data. I've said these are the building blocks of TLS, and now I will prove it to you. Let's go through the process a browser uses to set up a TLS encrypted connection step by step. I will still cut a few corners for simplicity, but nothing integral to the concept. The first step is having the server send you its certificate. The certificate contains the public key of the server, some additional information like the domain the certificate is for, and the signature by a certificate authority. The client checks if the domain is correct and also checks if the authority's signature is valid. As we already explored earlier, all browsers have a collection of certificate authorities including their public keys saved locally, so it is trivial to check if the signature is valid. Now the client generates a random key for a symmetric encryption to be used from here on in. The browser encrypts the random key with the server's public key and sends it over. This has two benefits. Symmetric encryption is much faster, more efficient, and scales better to big data compared to asymmetric encryption. But more importantly, the server will only be able to continue communicating if it is truly in possession of the private key and can decrypt the new random key. This effectively validates the server's identity. If all of this succeeds, a TLS connection has successfully been established and the HTTP protocol can take over. At this point, you will get the green padlock symbol in your browser's URL bar.